the rising sun. We're happy because we're alive. Nowhere to go, nothing to possess, and nothing to discover. As we sit, appreciation naturally dawns in the space of our mind. Gratitude arises when we are awake. With gratitude present, our mind rises like the morning sun, and wisdom light streams into our mind. If we check our mind dispassionately, we can see its oscillations. When we sit in meditation, it balances, and we gain insight into its peaceful nature. We become physically and mentally used to sitting, abiding in the present moment, letting the layers of anxiety dissolve. After a while, we may be distracted by pain and stress arising in our body. We sit patiently, taking the time for this layer to shed, noticing and releasing, noticing and releasing. The releasing comes from the noticing, not from instructing ourselves to release. When boredom arises, let it pass. Engage with the present moment. When the mind dips, we may begin to feel sorry for ourselves. Gazing with open awareness, reflect how this is a setting sun star mind, and gently let it pass. Learning to enjoy the impermanent nature of the sunset. As we deeply abide, gratitude arises, and we can naturally let go. Meditation gives us insight, which encourages our mind to rise. We can appreciate whatever is appearing to our mind. Our entire life experience improves. We potentially have an underlying sense of needing to be busy all the time. Our mind space occupied with the tinkering and adjusting of our external situation. The endless attempt to improve our life by altering and changing our outer world. Feeling the only way to be useful is to be busy and analytical. We can experience guilt when we just sit somewhere thinking, maybe I should be doing something useful. If we can recognize and appreciate that the quality of our world ultimately depends on the quality of our mind, we will put more effort into exploring and gaining insight into the nature of our mind. When we go on meditation retreat, we step back from the external busyness. Retreat is an excellent opportunity to explore the mind, but requires patience. When we train in patience, we practice the patience of voluntarily enduring suffering, being able to experience problems without flapping. We learn to cultivate the habit of stillness when challenges and difficulties arise. Begin to cultivate the attitude in meditation. I'm just going to sit and accept. If, when we sit, we start to feel uncomfortable, take the time to explore the mind that sees this as a problem and that immediately wishes to experience comfort. Let it pass. See through the pain. Over time, we can develop a balanced mind that allows stillness and relaxation to arise. As a result of training in this way, we can enjoy the arising of our world as it appears in each moment, building up our resilience to the challenges. Enjoying an inner strength due to the training of the mind. We may think when we hear this that it's hard, or that we won't be good at it. Bear in mind, however, these are just thoughts. Let them pass. Merely abide and explore their nature. Where do they come from? Where do they go? There's a famous Zen book entitled Being No One, Going Nowhere. This title gives us a clue. When we sit, we may think strongly to ourselves, I am meditating. We have this sense of I am meditating. When engaging in Zen practice, we're not doing anything, not even meditating. just for 2 minutes or so, imagine anything you wish to let go of from the year goes onto the fire and burns into emptiness. Dedicate all your positive actions for healing across the world.